One of our elders, Imran Ihsan Sahib, says, he says, you are going there and wasting your time in the marketplace, not taking the stomach of that place, buying things there, saying you are seeking the barakat of that place. Don't you realize that those things that you are buying are not made there, they are exported there, they are made elsewhere by people whose every day is in sharab and every night is in zina, and you say the sand of Makkah and Medina has touched it so it became blessed. If you wanted the blessing of that place, bring the sand of that place. The sabak of New Year, the reminder of New Year, the reminder of Muharram, the reminder of the sabak of Zilhijjah, of Hajj. Stand on the plain of Mina and turn the clock back 1428 years. Go beyond that to the 13 years of Nubuwwat of that Mubarak Nabi. What did he do in Mina? 10 to 10, person to person. May you uini, may ansuruni, hatta uballigha risalata rabbi. Who is there that will shelter me? Who is there that will become my nasir, my helper? To do what? What was he inviting the kuffar of that time to? That the mu'min of today hasn't said labbaik to. Hatta uballigha risalata rabbi. So that I can make tabligh of this deen. One youngster, he says, I stood on the mountain of Abu Qubais and I looked down. At Mina, I saw this person, 10 to 10, person to person. فَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ تَفَلَ فِي وَجْهِ. Some people spat in his face. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ حَثَى عَلَيْهِ التُّرَابِ. Some picked up sand and flung it at him. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ سَبَّ عَلَى وَجْهِ. They swore him, they scoffed him, they mocked him, they insulted him, they relentlessly beat him. Yet he said he carried on and on and on in Mina. حَتَّنْ تَصَفَ النَّهَارِ. Until the sun reached its zenith. He said on in exhaustion, a young girl came running. She wiped his face. He looked at her and said, لَا تَخْشَيْ عَلَى أَبِيكِ الْغَيْلَ. Do not fear. Allah will not disgrace your father. He said, I asked my father, who is that person? My father told me that is Muhammad bin Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa. And the young girl was Zainab radiallahu ta'ala anha. 10 years, in the 11th year finally 6 people come. Abu Haytham bin Tayhan, Ubadah bin Samit, Abdullah bin Rawaha, Asad bin Zurara, Nu'man bin Haritha, and Saad bin Rabi radiallahu anhum. 11th year, 6. 12th year, 12 people came. 13th year, 72, amongst which were two women, Umm Mani and Umm Ammara radiallahu ta'ala anhum. And they take a bayat. They take an oath of allegiance on his hand. What bayat did they take? What was that oath of allegiance on which Allah sent down the command of hijrat? That, oh my Nabi, now you and the muhajireen of Makkah, leave your home, leave your businesses, leave your possessions, leave everything and make hijrat to Medina Munawwara. That hijrat on which the Islamic calendar started, that hijrat which this ummah every Muharram is supposed to be reminded about, that hijrat, that cry of Mina which the Hujjaj are supposed to return with every year, and the ummah internationally is supposed to be reminded about, it is encapsulated, the significance of it, in the warning that was issued to the people of Medina by Ubadah, by Abbas bin Ubadah radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He addressed that majma. Listen with the ears of Iman. Listen to the warning that he issues. He said, هَلْ تَدْرُونَ عَلَى مَا تُبَايِعُونَ هَذَا الرَّجُلِ. Ya Ahl al-Khazraj, O people of Medina, O people of Yathrib, do you realize what you are doing? By putting your hand, by saying labbaik to the call of this individual, of this Nabi of Allah, do you know what you are doing? تبايعونه على حرب الأحمر والأسود من الناس. He said, it is not a possibility, it is not a probability, it is not a likelihood, it is an absolute certainty that when you will place your hand in the hand of this Nabi and you will take him to Medina Munawwara, it is an absolute certainty that you have declared war with the entire humanity. The whole world will turn against you. Unhikat amwalukum musiba. You will become poor. Your businesses will fail. Your homes will be emptied of their food. Wa ashrafukum qatla. Your senior members of your society will be slaughtered. The streets of Medina will flow with your blood. Do you realize what you are doing by taking this bayat? What was the question of this jamaat? What was the question of this jamaat? O Nabi of Allah, if we place our hand in your hand, if we hand ourselves over to you and Allah, what will Allah give us? He says, Allah will give you Jannat. Ubsut yadak. Stretch out your hand, O Nabi of Allah. من المؤمنين رجال من المؤمنين رجال صدقوا ما عاهدوا الله عليه فمنهم من قضى نحبه ومنهم من ينتظر وما بدلوا تبديلا. Quran says amongst the believers are men. Are men who have fulfilled the covenant with Allah. Who have fulfilled the covenant with Allah. Some have given their lives. Some are waiting to give their lives. For what? So that this entire humanity embraces the call of Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So that this entire humanity is saved from Jahannam and goes into Jannah. So that this entire humanity is embraced by the fikr and the cry of that same Nabi who finished himself for 23 years. Who night upon night cried for this ummah. For that was their bayat. For that was their oath of allegiance. And on that the Islamic calendar started. Muharram, each year, is a reminder of Aqaba, is a reminder of the oath which Sahaba took in Mina, is a reflection for this ummah. Renew your covenant, renew your contract with Allah. Understand that your purpose and your object in this world is that you are muballigh of Allah's deen. Just one of those individuals. On this I will terminate. There are so many incidents. Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu shahadat, first of Muharram he was buried. Imam Hussein radiallahu ta'ala anhu, incident of Karbala. What more sabr do we want? Sa'd bin Rabi', one of the Ahl Khazraj who took the oath on the hands of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Uhud. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam looks for him. Cannot find him. Zayd bin Harisa is sent. He comes to Sa'd bin Rabi' wa fihi ramaq. He is on the last breath of his life. Zayd bin Harisa says, Nabi of Allah has asked me to ask you, what is your condition? He said, tell the Nabi of Allah, ajiduni, ajidu riha al-jannah, I can smell jannat. Tell Allah's Rasul, I can smell jannat. And tell him, may Allah reward him more than any other Nabi has been rewarded. And on the last breath of his life, what is his message? What is his message? He says, go to my brothers of the Ansar. Go to my brothers who took the oath in Aqaba. Go to my brothers who took the oath in Mina. And tell them, La udhra lakum in khulisa ila nabiyikum wa fikum aynun tatrah. Tatraf, if there is one breath left in your body, and your eyelashes are moving, and the Nabi of Allah is harmed, tomorrow on the day of judgment, I will hold you responsible in front of Allah. Saying this, he gives his life. Muharram each year is to remind the ummah globally of that commitment and that covenant which we made with Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is a time of renewing our commitment. It is a time of reflection. It is not a time of revelry and it is not a time of rejoicing. New year is a reminder of qabr, new year, and every birthday is not milestones of our life. To complete the riwayat of Abu Darda radiallahu anhu, he said, innama anta ayyam, insan, you are a collection of days. In dhahaba yawmun dhahaba ba'duk, every new year, every birthday is a reminder that a portion of you is gone which will never come back again. So how can you possibly celebrate? May Allah ta'ala give us tawfiq wa akhirah. Alhamdulillah.